In this lesson, we will learn to conduct a load flow analysis in Etap. I will have to open my project. So I will go to the file. I will go to open project. Then I will have to select my project from the folder. This is over. Yeah, over here. I have my project open. I'll click on OK. Okay, I will close the system dumpster and I will open this. Okay, so we are right back at where we have drawn our single line diagram. So before we have to go into this load flow analysis mode, we will have to enter into our values of all the elements. So I'll double click on the power grid over here. So this is put at swing over here. You can see this has many tabs such as rating, short circuit, harmonics and so on. Every element has number of tabs which we can use, and at the end we have these remarks which are user defined information which we are providing into these elements, such as we can provide the manufacturer name, purchasing date, and we can add these comments over here. So I will go to the info, and here in the info we have the ID as U1. We can edit this over here, and this is already connected to our bus 1 as shown. So I can also take this out of service. This is same for all the elements over here. If I click on out, this will be out of service, and we can also change this over here, the state of power grid. Okay, we can also lock in the data over here. Nothing will be changed, so I'll unlock it. So I will go to the rating over here, and this power grid will be rated for 110 kV volts, and this will be a balanced supply. So I'll go to the short circuit and I will provide a 3-phase MVA level as 1000, and the X by R ratio to be 7. So here Etap automatically calculated the positive sequence, negative sequence and zero sequence resistances and reactances. So we don't have to input these values over here. It automatically calculates and puts these values for us. So I will leave everything over here and I will click on OK. So now if you see that the buses have already changed to 110 kV bus over here and over here. So let me go to the transmission line. I will double click on over here. And you see we have again different number of tabs over here, which have parameter configuration and depends upon the elements which are used. And for the info tab, it will be mostly the same. It will contain the info, this locking option over here, condition, and over here we have the length. I will change it to about like 5 kilometers. Let me change this, and maybe I will give a tolerance of like 5%. Okay, so we will go into the parameters over here. Here we have the conductor library, or if you want to enter these values manually, you could do that, but I prefer to use the conductor library. So let me select a conductor. I'll select this over here and I'll click on OK. So this loads up over here. And similarly for the ground wire, I'll select that, and everything comes into place. So next I will go to the configuration. So I will select I'll keep it on the horizontal one. Let me enter a random height. I'm not sure what height we should use for a 110 kV system, but for the sake of explanation, let me put some value. Okay, 30 feet. Then for spacing, I will use like 3 feet. That's it. And I will use one ground wire, which is like of it from these conductors. So that's it. And if we want to transpose, we can click over here and provide this over here, but I'm not going to transpose it. So everything else I will be putting as default, and I will click on OK. And next we will come to the transformer. So I'm going to double click on the transformer. So we have the info tab, and it is connected between the primary to secondaries, bus 2 and bus 3. I can change the standard, change the connection to anything I want. Let's go to the rating page. On the rating, I have the primary at 110. I will make the secondary at 11 kV. So then I will fill the power rating as 12.5 MVA. So this automatically brings the full load current, that is about 65 amps for the primary and 656 for the secondary. And everything else I will keep it the same. If you want, you can change any of these. So I will go to the impedance, which I will have to fill. And these are usually manufacturer data, but I will click on the typical values. So this fills up these values of X by R, R by X and ratios. And here also I will click on the typical values, and everything else I will keep as default and click on OK. So now we have the bus 3 as 11 kV, and here also we have 11 kV, here also we have 11 kV. So I'll double click on the cable to select a particular cable. So let us see. Okay, over here we will put some length of 10 feet, and the library, I will click on the library to open the library. size, so I will click on OK, and this will fill in all the other details, so nothing to worry about. So I'll click on OK. And if your cable is not rated for the current that will be flowing through this line, then we will get a notification about it, so you don't have to worry as of now. However, the load flow will take place even if you don't rate your cable appropriately. So again, here I will provide 15 feet link into the library. I will select a particular size. Let me see. Okay, I'll click on 262, then I will click on OK. Then everything else I will remain same. I'll click on OK. So here also, then to the lump load, let me see, I will provide a 2 megawatt load with from 0.5 MVAR, and that automatically puts the power factor at 97%, and the MVA is already calculated over here. You can use this calculator also for the same, and we can change the model type over here. And this is okay, this is all in the right values, so I'll click on OK. Here same but different values. Just take one and put this over 3, so 94% power factor with 166 amps. Okay, that's fine. Let's click on OK. And over here we have this network over here. Let me put some value over here as well. NW 1.5 MVAR. Okay, and that's done. And switch back to the, so in order to make things more interesting, I will be providing a generator on this bus 3. So let me connect this generator over here, and I'll double click on it and go to the rating. So here you can see the operation mode is already under the voltage control mode. We cannot go to the swing mode because we already have a swing mode, so I will go to the voltage mode. The rating, I will rate this generator for, we usually rate generators in VAs, but here for the sake of calculation they have done it like this, so we'll put in a value of 2 megawatts, so the MVA calculated becomes about 2.3, which is good. So let me see to the capability curve. Okay, the capability curves. So for, I will have to put in a value like 1.5, I guess. Okay, operational, so the normal I will put 1.5. Okay, we will put it like this and see if anything goes wrong, we will be alerted of it. So I'll click on OK.